life without parole for the mother. That is exactly what you wanted.
Yes, we did. And we're very pleased with the sentencing that Judge McCormick just meted out this afternoon.
Can you talk about you made the pitch to have them be in solitary confinement on the anniversary of her death each year. What was the thought process behind that?
The thought process behind that is that people should think about their actions, and when they're actually committing them, I don't think they actually think about it. But in this case, she spent 3 long months before the paramedics whisked her to the hospital, lying in a pool of urine. And so they should sit there and think about all the activities that they did as she lied there. And they didn't do anything to help her. And that's what saddens me the most about this case, that as human beings, we have a responsibility to one another. And they failed her miserably, whether as a mother, whether as a mother's good friend, a mother's boyfriend. Human being folks kill human beings. Agencies don't kill them. And in this case, that's what happened. Human beings killed this child.
What message does this send to other potential parents who are being not good stewards of their children?
Harry, I think that it sends a message that this community is no longer going to tolerate this kind of behavior as parents. There are so many people out there that are willing to help. You can drop a baby off in Ohio at a fire station, at a police department, at a hospital, and nobody's going to question you. If you can't cope with your own child, seek help. And we can't stress that enough, because just like Aniya Day died on March 11th, there are other children subsequent to her that have died following that. These are young parents that don't have coping skills, don't know what to do. Seek help. Help is out there. And families need to be vigilant as well. If you haven't seen a child in a couple of days, ask where that child is. You saw what the aunt did in this case. She tried to help. She knew her sister's proclivities, and yet they weren't able to get the help that they needed.
And this has been a difficult case for you. I know they all have, but this seems to be, you kind of said in there, it's something you're always going to remember.
Those pictures will forever be etched, and anybody who ever saw those pictures, it will be etched in your mind, because that little girl did not need to die the death she died. They're awful.
Are you pleased with the 20-year sentence for Deontay?
I'm pleased with the verdict that this judge obviously thought long and hard about it, and I think he held accountable the person that actually harmed this child from the beginning.
During the 6-day trial, very few, if any, reactions from Sierra Day, very few, if any, reactions from Deontay Lewis. Your thoughts on that?
They're only known to themselves why they don't speak, why they don't say anything, why they don't act, because I think deep down they know what they did. So what kind of reaction could they really have? Because it would be a falsity. I mean, they would be committing, it's false to shed a tear when you know you were in and out of that apartment days and hours before and she was dead. I mean, come on. I think they knew at least enough about that.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, everybody.
Okay. Are we streaming, Pleasure? Because the father might be coming out.
Yeah, it should be all right.
Okay. Michael, how are you? How are you feeling?
This is a very blessed day and a very blessed moment for myself, my family, and my daughter. We have gained some justice today. We're going to continue to still seek justice, so justice continues for Aniya. There was a lot of failed parties in protecting Anaya's life, and we're going to do whatever it takes with the Justice for Aniya Foundation to make sure we protect all our children. We'd like to thank our judge and our jury for coming up with a great, reasonable, excellent verdict that was very fair also. We'd like to thank the news media. Thank you all for all your support also again. And thank all our supporters out there around the world and our community rooting on justice for Aniya.
She's looking down on your
after having walked out of this courtroom with some modicum of justice and vindication. Talk about her looking down on you now.
Yes, I know my daughter is with each and every one of us every single moment, protecting us as an angel should and as an angel would. It was very tough, you know, in this courtroom, you know, going through this trial. But whatever it took, we stood strong and stood firm for Aniya, you know, as a unity, as family.
And you are still hoping to get some answers from the Department of Children and Family Services, right?
Yes, truly. There's a lot of answers from, you know, Children and Family Services and a number of others. So we just want to make sure we bring change here in our community to protect our children. We want to bring change all around the world. We want to make sure we bring awareness to the Aniya Law and protect our children. We need our government officials, our state senators to help support the Aniya Law also.
What did you make of Sierra remaining quiet and Deontay saying those words?
To me, it's just a lack of parenting, a lack of love, a lack of care. But whatever it takes, you know, I'm a father who will never give up on my children. So we're going to continue to love each and every one of our babies and make sure their futures be most important in our lives.
How did you feel when Deontay said he loved Aniya?
It was fake. I didn't believe it. None of it. You know, if you love a child, you'll protect the child. You know, you'll do whatever it takes to make sure a child stays alive. So to me, it was all false.
You really gave some thought to what you said in there. You talked about these monsters ruined your life. You quoted Alexander Hamilton. You wove a very compelling story. What was your hope that the court would hear what from you today? What was the message you really wanted to make clear?
The message I wanted to make clear was the beautiful angel and princess that Aniya Marie Garrett is, the 4-year-old, smart, intelligent little girl who tried to save her own life and told each and every person that encountered her that her life was in danger. Help me. I want the world to know that Aniya tried to save her own life and Aniya saved the world, because changes are being made here in Cuyahoga County and around the world every day behind the death of my daughter.
And Michael, what do you remember of your daughter? What do you want people to remember about her?
Oh, everything. My daughter loves to look beautiful. She loved to be smart. She loved to eat. I think we all like
Definitely.
To eat, so yes.
What was her favorite?
Chicken, you know, French fries, and salad, anything healthy. I try to keep them healthy.
Do you think the death penalty should have been applicable here?
Death penalty too easy. You know, and it's really hard to say. There's really no words for this, you know. But I just like to, I'm thankful that some justice did come out of this.
And what can you say about the folks behind you, this army that you have behind you?
Oh. This is my family. This is, you know, all our supporters for Aniya. We're fighting each and every day, you know, to protect all our children with the Justice for Aniya organization. Whatever it takes, that's what we're going to do.
You talked about Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and justice. Talk a little bit more about that.
Yes, as we all know, that is a civil rights leader and hero. I encourage anybody out there to please, you know, follow our civil rights leaders, because, you know, they have paved the way and created a lot of opportunities for us all.
When the prosecutor asked that Sierra and Deontay have spent March 11th in solitary, is that something that you would like to see happen?
Sure. Anything that's going to bring more justice for Aniya, yes.